Hello, I'm Stephen Kuplik, product manager here at MTS Systems. Damper software is the standard application software used worldwide on both linear electric and servo hydraulic damper test systems. Today, we join Spencer Neitz, MTS Systems Integration Engineer, as he demonstrates velocity preservation, a powerful optional feature of MTS damper software. Velocity preservation uses a feed-forward iterative model to optimize servo controller commands, enabling a servo hydraulic test system to accurately produce specific maximum velocities while maintaining the desired wave shape. This allows you to run higher velocity test profiles with high waveform fidelity without having to retune the test system.
As shown here on the scope on the right, this was a plus or minus 25 millimeter, 10 hertz waveform played out to this specimen on the rig. The peak-to-peak displacement feedback amplitude was 45.8 millimeters when I asked for plus or minus 25, which would be a total of 50 millimeters. Because it's a higher frequency waveform, this system naturally tends to undershoot. To combat that, you can either change the PID gains for each type of waveform you run, or which will impact all waveforms, or you can use the velocity preservation tool on specific waveforms that have trouble. We will be using the velocity preservation tool. So we'll over here to the damper software. We're going to add in a performance test step and then select the sine wave file from the dropdown, and we're going to rerun that same waveform to see how the velocity preservation tool runs. So this will be a 50 millimeter peak-to-peak amplitude with an offset of minus 25 to pull it down around plus or minus 25 millimeters around zero. And then everything else is correct. We will click the sine wave iteration button, and that will bring up the model in the lower left-hand corner and the sine wave iteration box here. Now clicking iterate sends our ideal command through the model, and it will display to us what command it thinks it should send to the rig. So I click the iterate button, and this is the command that the model thinks it should send to the rig at this time. We're going to verify that it's safe to use on the rig, and we can see that it's around plus or minus 22 millimeters in amplitude, so it's actually undershooting a small amount. The iteration process will remove the errors from that command. So now we're going to run that command on the rig. So since that was safe, we're going to run it. So if we watch, I'll grab my scope and then click the run button. And now the system has run, the velocity versus time chart has popped up from the data that has just run on the system. Since this is deviating, so it's undershooting in velocity, we need to overprogram essentially. And that's what the iteration will do. So next I will click iterate again to send my my error back through the model to compensate it. Now, as you can see, we're now overprogramming, plus or minus 26 or 27 millimeters. I'm going to change my limits. And we're going to run the system again. Now, as you can see, the velocity's increased. We're going to continue to iterate until the wave shape looks good and the velocities are acceptable. And each time I'm very quickly looking for the limits and ensuring that this is safe to run on the system. A little bit more. We're getting close. I'm just watching the lower velocity limit. And let's do one more, and then we can inspect. Okay, so this looks very sinusoidal. If I zoom in on the peaks, I can see that we're within 1% error. And that is as desired. Next, we would save this file, and then we could run it as its own test. So I've saved the file, I close out of the iteration process, I say okay, and now I have a performance test step in a test and damper that I can then run and evaluate against my desired profile. Based on the data here, you can see from our last run, we hit about plus or minus 49.8 millimeters in displacement, and our velocity has vastly improved. That is the goal of the velocity preservation option, and we have not changed our PID gains at all. That is the extent of the velocity preservation option.
Thank you for watching this video. To learn more about the growing portfolio of MTS damper test solutions, please contact your local sales representative or visit us at mts.com.